The age-old question, AMD or Intel? My objective of this video is not to tell you which is better, but rather to equip you with the skills to make the decision yourself. Because telling you what is good today won't be relevant in a few months or even a few weeks. And that's because of pricing. Pricing in Singapore is constantly changing and it's never the same as the overseas MSRP. And this is why overseas reviews are not applicable to the Singapore market. Because a big part of reviews to overseas reviewers is pricing. And if the pricing is not the same overseas and in Singapore, then basically it's not very relevant lah, to Singaporeans at least. So that's why I'm making this video. And if you ask any logical person about Intel or AMD, they will never give you a straight answer because there's a lot of factors to consider when you choose a CPU. And one big factor, and I'm gonna say it again, for the majority of gamers is price. But even for gamers, the choice of CPU is dependent on the games you play. For example, CSGO is a CPU intensive game. No, not really. Intensive is not the word, but the better your single core performance of your CPU, you tend to get better performance for CSGO and Valorant as well. Other factors include, will you be using video editing software, 3D software, or streaming software? Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is to give your PC specification ranging from entry-level gaming PC to high-end gaming workstation PC with the current market of CPU choices. As I said, I want to equip you with the skills instead of just telling you what to get. So I've got a list in the description with all the current CPU prices and performance. For the performance, I'll just add the R23 Cinebench performance. I'll update it once a month, and if anything changes, you can compare it for yourself. I've also added motherboards and RAMs into the list because this will factor into the final price, which must be added into consideration. Let's start with the entry range 1080p gaming, price around 1000 to 1200. Here are the CPUs from each brand to consider. 5500, 5600, the 5600G, 5600X for the AMD side. For Intel side, is the 12100F and the 12400F. I did not add the 12500 and 12600 because these CPU prices are more towards the mid-range side at above 300. Let's first compare AMD CPUs starting with the 5500. As you can see, the 5500 price is not much lower than the 5600. Unless the 5500 is a lot cheaper, only then I will consider the 5500. Hence, at the moment, I'm not going to even consider the 5500. Kapuy, go away. Next, the 5600G, 5600 and the 5600X. The performance gain for the 5600 to the 5600G in gaming with a GPU is about 10%. I can only see you using the 5600G if you don't plan to get a GPU and maybe getting a GPU later on. So 5600G, siam. The 5600 and the 5600X have similar performance, but the 5600X is higher in price. The only difference in that is that you'll be able to overclock the 5600X. So for AMD CPU in the entry range, I would say the 5600 is the best in value CPU at $192. But if you choose to overclock, if you want to try overclocking, if overclocking is something you want to do, you can spend more and get the 5600X for $234. As for motherboard and RAM, I'll pair it with the Gigabyte B550M DS3H at $145 and 2x8GB Clef Crest XR RGB 3600 MHz at $95, totaling the cost to $432 for the whole set. Now for the Intel side, the 12100F is $150, but with only 4 cores as compared to 6 cores on the 5600, which will affect its performance. While the 12400F is $248, both have its place in the entry range. Let's add the motherboard to this, which will be the Gigabyte B660M DS3H DDR4 at $159. And let's use the same RAM as the AMD version, which is the 2x8GB Clef Crest XR RGB at $95. Totaling the cost to $404 for the 12100F and $502 for the 12400F. With these three CPUs, we can look at the benchmarks to see which has the best value. Although the 12400F performance is better in gaming compared to the 5600, the improvement is small, making the extra $70 steep. So I rather choose the 5600 over the 12400F. The 12100F, on the other hand, is about 7% cheaper and does sometimes perform similar in gaming with the RTX 3060. The reason why I say that is because higher GPUs like the RTX 3080 will be bottlenecked more with the 4 cores. So with this, you can make a decision. The 12100F is your ultimate cheapest build, but you might not be able to upgrade your GPU to the higher end in the future as it may bottleneck the GPU. Or you can get the 5600, a balanced value CPU. For me, at this current price, I would choose the 5600 CPU with an RTX 3060 Ti, which I saw online had a good deal for $450. Wow. Add a Gen 3 SSD, an affordable case, 750 watt power supply, and a CPU cooler, about $300 for everything. And you're looking at a PC below $1,200 that can play all games at 1080p ultra settings. You can stream, but simultaneously streaming on this PC will affect gameplay quite a bit. Honestly, you also can edit, but don't expect to edit 4K videos smoothly. That said, editing TikTok videos shouldn't be a problem. For the mid-range, it's a little tricky. There's so many combinations, and also a lot of people have different needs. But let's give a budget of $2,000 to $2,500. Assuming you will do some light streaming, play games at 1440p. The CPU I will look at on the AMD side will not include the 5000 series, but instead the 7000 series. Because the 5000 series at this price range is obsolete due to the lower single core performance, which will impact gaming performance, especially CSGO and Valorant. So we are looking at either the 7600X at $459 or the 7700X at $599. So the motherboard I will pair with this CPU is the ASRock B650PG Riptide at $268 and DDR5 RAM, because the 7000 series has no backwards compatibility for RAM. 2x8 Kingston Fury Beast Black, 4800 mega transfers for $141. It's not the fastest, but it's affordable. Totaling the cost to $868 for the 7600X option and $1,008 for the 7700X option. For Intel, the 12th gen is obsolete because of price and performance. Example, the 13600K is cheaper and better than the 12600K. So the CPUs we will look at is the 13600K at $460, 13600KF, $418, 13700K 669, and 13700KF 615. The good thing about the 13th gen is that you can use the previous 600 series motherboard, which is cheaper, and you'll be able to use DDR4 RAM. Even a new Intel 700 series motherboards, some also support DDR4 RAM. So the Gigabyte B660M DS3H DDR4 for $159 is very appealing for this CPU. And using DDR4 RAM, the same choice of 2x8GB Clevcrest XR RGB at $95. The current total is $672 for the 13600KF, $714 for 13600K, $869 for 13700KF, $923 for the 13700K. Okay, yeah. You can see lah, supers. Just looking at everything, it's clear that Intel will give you a better value because you'll be able to use DDR4 RAM. But the question is, will using last gen RAM with last gen model motherboard affect gaming performance? And the answer is very minimal. At the moment, games and software ain't utilizing fast memory. So I think the clear option at the current market is going for the Intel 13th gen option with DDR4. For the option of K or KF, from what I researched, having K with integrated graphics will help with video editing and 3D software. So if you're planning to use the PC to edit or 3D software, then paying a bit more for the K version might be an option for you. For getting the 13600 or the 13700, it's all about if you want to get more performance in your CPU and also whether you can pay more lah. With this PC, you can pair it with the RTX 3080, pricing around $1,050, with a case, storage, CPU cooler, and 850 watts power supply. That's around $630. So the final price is about $2,252 to 2,603. A bit overpriced, but it's okay. Range, options. With this mid-range configuration, you'll be able to play games at 1440p as well as edit in 4K pretty well. Do note that streaming will affect your gameplay a little. Just a little, not as much as the entry range, but still a little. Okay, last but not least, the high-end range where the budget is at least about $4,000. Like, it can be $3,000 to like 10K lah. With custom water loop, you can like spend crazy amounts of money, but yeah. We are looking at the 13900K and 13900KF for Intel side and the 7950X and 7900X for the AMD side. At this range, you would want to get a good motherboard with a good VRM, high DDR5 RAM speeds, and at least a 36mm AIO cooler. Because these CPUs get hot. The prices are pretty much the same here in terms of motherboard, RAM, CPU cooler. The thing is, you still can get DDR4 RAM for Intel's option, but at this range, might as well go for DDR5. So just looking at the performance without the price, the 13900K and 13900KF is the fastest CPU in the market. But when putting both Intel and AMD CPUs to its max 100% usage, the power efficiency for AMD's is better. However, if you're going to game, the CPU will not hit the 100% usage, and the AMD 7950X power draw is actually higher than the 13900K. The 13900K also does better in terms of gaming performance. But this doesn't mean a thing if the CPUs are not priced right. So looking at the price, currently the 7950X is more expensive than the 13900K. And the 7900X is not much cheaper than the 13900KF. So if I were to choose, I would choose the 13900K for the high range. But I do predict that AMD will drop its price very soon. So like I said, check back description, price list. I would say because of my work, I need a PC to edit, game, and stream. This high range is my range. Accompanying the 13900K, I will go for the ASUS Prime Z790A Wi-Fi motherboard, a 360mm AIO cooler, G-Scale Trident Z5 RGB Silver 2x16GB DDR5 6400 mega transfer, a RTX 4090 GPU, 1TB Gen 4 NVMe SSD, 4TB hard drive, 1000W 80+ gold PSU, and a good case like a Lianli O11 Dynamic Evo. This will total the cost to around $5,900. Yes, expensive, I know, expensive. But like I said, I'm here not to tell you which is better, but to give you the skills to choose your own CPU. I'm sure in the future, AMD will drop their prices, like I said just now, and it will be more appealing for consumers. So again, check the price list. I do. Actually, my intern do lah. But we work very hard, so check. There are also other aspects that I didn't mention or didn't go much in depth, like temperatures, power efficiency, branding, I don't know. Because I believe at the end of the day, price is what matters to most of you. But if you really want to go super detailed, you can also factor these two aspects about the CPU into your consideration. Like, Singapore hot lah, temperature high lah, maybe lah. I hope this video has been helpful to you. I do want to do a GPU bias guide too, especially because this will affect gaming performance more than CPUs. However, I'm just waiting for all the GPUs to be released from both AMD's 7000 series and NVIDIA's 4000 series GPUs. So do show your support by liking this video, share to your friends, and subscribing. A lot of people not subscribe. About 69% of you, no, 70% of you are not subscribed. I know. I check the analytics. Subscribe. We are trying to get 30,000 subscribers very soon. I want to get the... This will let me know if the demand for this kind of video is good. We do. We make a lot of work. We put in a lot of work. Don't forget, there are links in the description to all the prices. Again, reminder, and I'll do my best to update it monthly, okay? Hope you have a good week. Enjoy your week. School holidays coming. Christmas is coming. Merry Christmas. And I am done. Now we can like maybe add the bloopers. One blooper. And then peep. And then done. Yes, I hope this video has been helpful for you. To you. That was a dyslexic moment. I just said to you twice.